Hey, what's up boys, it's Fox2, welcome back to the channel. In today's video, we have with us the only Chinese tank platoon we currently have in the game, and that is the ZTZ88A platoon. This platoon is a pretty fun platoon. It's okay, I've enjoyed it a little bit when I play it. I haven't played it a lot because I haven't done a ton of the top tier vehicles much, because I'm always grinding the levels using my premium vehicles. But this platoon is pretty interesting. It's not really very strong. It's quite mediocre and it actually has quite a few weaknesses. But it's also got its strong sides as well. The main drawback to this whole platoon is the fact that the two main vehicles are old technology with upgrades to modernize them, so they're actually not that modern, even though they look pretty modern. So starting off with the ZTZ88A, it still resembles things like the old T-54s, which China obviously borrowed a lot of technology from the Soviets, including a T-54 especially, and the Type 59 predecessor of this tank. The difference it carries now is its 105mm gun, a more powerful engine giving you 57km an hour top speed with 19 horsepower per ton. And the other main difference is the fact that it has a new hull. The hull, it still resembles in shape the old Type 59 and the T-54, but it is much better angled, giving you a higher ricochet rate and slightly better armor as well. But its turret protection is very, very weak. The turret can be penetrated by most tanks, especially tanks with very high penetration, like our new French top tier platoon or the Leopard A1A1. So yeah, it's more or less mediocre because it's old technology that has been upgraded. Its gun though is a very decent point. But otherwise, for me, the weak turret is a big drawback, because for me, the turret is probably the most important part to have heavily armored, because most people prefer playing hull down and having only your turret peeking out behind a rock or a hill or whatever. You cannot do this in this tank because of that. Then we have the ZTZ-59D1. What's an interesting looking tank, but still, once again, old technology that has been upgraded. This tank is probably worse than the ZTZ88A, even though it looks more modern with all of that spaced armor blocks added to it. What is wrong with this tank? Pretty much everything. First of all, it actually carries an original T-54 hull. Literally, the hull is just an original T-54 hull with some minor modifications, such as that spaced armor blocks they've added onto the front, which are very sparse, so it doesn't make too much of a difference. And you've got to take into account the T-54 was designed by the Soviet Union to counter World War II German vehicles, not to counter modern vehicles at this era that you're seeing. Well, early modern, more or less Cold War to early modern now that we're seeing in this tier. The other drawback is, even though it's got a 105mm gun, it's got poor gun handling and a very long reload compared to its counterparts at this rank. Its turret is also very, very weak, carrying a modified T-54/Type 59 turret as well. And it's very slow and sluggish too. Even though it says 50km an hour top speed, it's hard to reach that. And both of these have a very slow reverse speed, making it hard to get out of any bad situations. Then the CM25 ATGM carrier, it's pretty decent. It's a more or less average ATGM carrier. It's not as good as its Swedish counterpart, which packs more penetration, but it's still a very good vehicle in my opinion. I don't really have any complaints against this. And then we have the SPAA, the PGZ-09. Now this, it's interesting. It's pretty much like a Jeopard in its playstyle. It's very similar to a Jeopard. Obviously, it's got the further back turret, but the drawback, I think, of this vehicle is it's very, very large. As you can see, It's actually larger than the other main battle tanks in this rank, in this platoon. So that's what I really don't like about it, the size. It's got no armor and it's really huge. I feel like the Gepard and the Japanese counterparts are both smaller, making them a lot easier and better to play. This thing is a very easy target because it is so big. All right, this is taking a while. Okay, there we've now got a battle. Let us see, what map have we been given today by Gaijin? All right, taking a very long time to load. It's pretty unusual doing this. All right, we've got Stalingrad with three bases currently. I think I'm gonna push base B, but I'm gonna have to be pretty cautious about it because, like I said, it's a pretty underwhelming platoon on most aspects. All right, I'm gonna push this side here, and I'm gonna try take a shooting position over here. Okay, gonna try and just angle my tank a bit here, and hopefully we can get some good shots in. Uh-oh, let's get away, let's get away. This guy looks like he's driving a T-62, and it's a pretty challenging turret to penetrate. As you can see, it's such a flat tank, it's quite a pain to deal with a T-62 in situations like this. Okay, it looks like I've got annoying teammates getting in my way here. Okay, we've got another Chinese tank with a beautiful premium camouflage. I have to say, this is probably, though, the nicest premium camo in the game. I really love the premium camo that they have for this tank platoon. And okay, what was that random lag I just got there? That was pretty weird. Oh, just missed him there. Okay, let's now try and deal with base B here. I'm getting a bit concerned. We are lagging behind a bit. When it comes to enemies destroyed, we haven't gotten enough destroyed yet. Come on, let's try get this guy. Come on, re-peek. Uh-oh, we've got a T-62 looking at us. Come on. Okay, looks like we did his loader a bit of an injury there, but still we haven't taken him down yet. Okay, nobody to the flank there. Okay, we've got a guy, we've got a guy, we've got a guy here. Let's try deal with this guy here. Come on! No pen! Okay, we've still got the T-62 alive there. Looks like he took down our friendly tank right there. Nice! Fuel exploded. That is the very powerful 105mm gun we do pack. It's a high velocity cannon and it's got very good penetration on most vehicles. Okay, I'm gonna be heading out of the area now and try and cap base A here. Hopefully we won't have too many enemies to deal with. It looks like we had a pretty weak enemy team this time. They have not been seen. I mean, I've pretty much seen three enemies in this whole battle so far. Okay, we've got some guys on C there. Perhaps we can hit them with an artillery strike. Let's go for two there. The dispersion is pretty big, but maybe we can hit them. Also, want to keep an eye over here in case someone tries. Oh, we've got a guy going for B. We've got a guy going for B. Perhaps we can snipe him as he crosses. No. Looks like no sniping. Here he is, boom! Come on! So close, so close. Alright, let's try and make a move there for him now. Okay, we've got a T-114 over there. He's got a very big cannon. Oh, who's this? Who's this? Who's this? Come on, non-penetration, let's go. We've got a faster reload, we've got a faster reload. We can do this, we've got this. Come on. Yes, there. Crew knocked out through the turret ring. Very, very nice. And now I've just got to wait until my tracks repair themselves again. Okay, looks like we've got a guy there. I really want to go around and get him, but... Okay, there, our tracks are back up and running. Let's head straight for him there. There we go, crew knocked out. That was a pretty easy one. Okay, we've got a T-62. That might be... Yeah, I think that's the same one we saw earlier. Yes, fire, nice. Let's go, reload, reload. We should have a faster reload than him. Come on, let's go. Yes, there, crew knocked out through his hull. Uh-oh, we've got... Okay, looks like we have an M103 watching us here. Okay, now it's time to make the move. Oh, we only have Hesh left, so it looks... That's going to be a pretty big problem for us right now, because Hesh obviously doesn't have a whole lot of penetration for this tier. So... I'm going to have a hard time penetrating a lot of the enemies right now. And oh, looks like we're having a really odd glitch. Getting a lot of pixels. Really large pixels. Looking pretty Minecrafty here. Alright. Let's make my way around. Oh, looks like I just hit him in the track. Oh, man. Gun bounce. Come on. Come on, let's go. Oh, no pen, no pen. Let's go there. Nice, crew knocked out with the Hesh. Super, that was pretty good overpressure, I believe, through the whole tank. And I think it detonated his ammo rack on top of that over there. Okay, let's just hold here, cap this base. We're gonna have a guy coming around there. Come on, don't bump me. No pen, no pen, come on. Come on. Our track's damaged. Come on, we've got to survive this, we've got to survive this. Artillery strike there. And there, let's go. I think we can make this. And we're out of ammo, looks like. Oh, two shells left, two shells left. Alright, there, looks like the enemy finally managed to take us out, unfortunately. But we'll just respawn in our other tank that we have left. That was a pretty long survival rate. Pretty much the whole battle in one tank. Okay, looks like he's going for base C. Let's hope we can make it there quickly. Like I said, this tank, it's pretty sluggish. And it's... Turret turn rate is really, really miserable. I mean, look how slow the turret turns. Really, that is pretty dang lame. Okay, oh, just to the turret. Okay, looks like we did injure his crew there. And we've got this very long reload here. Let's go there. Crew knocked out. Nice. I think I hit the ammo rack. And who have we got here? Okay, looks like he's been destroyed. Nice. Let's just retake this base once again. And with that, the battle should be over pretty soon. Okay, I'm gonna make my way to use this pillar as some armor. Okay, never mind. We've got a guy coming down the alley, and we've got a guy trying to take base B there. Let's call for an RT strike there on him. Alright, let's get straight towards where his position was. Let's see, where's he, where's he, where's he, where's he? The teammate's probably going to get there first. He's got the better mobility. And, oh, who's here, who's here? Is there somebody? Okay, I think I've got a better chance of reaching these guys here first. Oh, looks like they just slipped away behind. Oh, miss, 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 miss. Okay, just calling for smoke grenades quickly. And let's make our way over to the next guy over there. Hopefully this... Okay, he's gone. He's not peeking anymore. And while the enemy sure is very keen On base C, they just keep recapping that. Okay, looks like we have a victory, first place in the team. 1,500 scores, that is a pretty decent battle. And 6 enemies destroyed, that is a pretty good battle, especially with a more or less mediocre platoon like this. That is pretty decent. As always, guys, let me know in the comments below what you guys think of this platoon. And if you enjoyed this video, please remember to like and subscribe. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching.